Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. not ruling out imposing curbs on travelers from China amid rising COVID cases there. In an interview with Press Undersecretary Chelo Garafil, Marcos stressed the government's decision will be based on science. Transport Chief Jaime Bautista earlier suggested conducting COVID tests on Chinese visitors upon arrival, but the Health Department sees no need for stricter protocols for now. It is confident existing protocols are adequate to prevent a COVID surge in the country.
Sa ngayon, base sa pananaw ng Department of Health, kasama ng aming mga eksperto, hindi pa po tayo napapanahon o wala po tayong nakikitang pangangailangan para magsara tayo ng borders specific to this specific country o di kaya ay magkaroon ng mas maigting na restrictions para sa mga sa bansang ito.
Marcos is pushing through with his three-day state visit to China next week. The Philippine Foreign Affairs Department says arrangements will be made to minimize the health risks to the president and his delegation.
We have received assurances from our Chinese hosts that all arrangements are being made to ensure the safety of the president and his delegation during the visit. And a bubble arrangement has been agreed for the Philippine delegation.
President Marcos not inclined on extending the country's COVID state of calamity. The Philippine government has been gradually easing various health measures against the pandemic.
Still very, very hesitant to continue the state of calamity, to extend it, because again, we are not in a state of calamity anymore, technically speaking. And that is the wrong mindset to be approaching the new year with. So we're still trying to find ways to continue to provide the benefits to our medical health workers, which is the main issue, without the state of calamity.
The Health Department has recommended a three-month extension of the state of calamity declaration. It warns lifting the state of calamity may weaken the country's COVID response strategies, especially its vaccination program.
The death toll from the weekend flooding that hit the southern Philippines is still rising. It's now at 44, with 28 others still missing. Social welfare officials have visited some of the affected areas in Misamis Occidental for an assessment. They vowed to provide financial help to the victims. Some of the evacuees in the province are now back home, but they had to deal with rising problems like the lack of water supply.
Wala tayong tubig. Kasi yung pinaka-main source ng tubig natin, yun ang unang natamaan. I think it will take us mga around 2 to 3 days more para maibalik namin.
Ang DSWD, ang kanyang mandate is food and non-food items. Ang mga tinitingnan namin ngayon, ano ang urgent at saka ano ang pwede pang ipamahagi dito.
A magnitude 5.2 earthquake rocks the Philippine province of Davao Oriental Thursday night. The quake struck 58 kilometers southeast of Governor Generoso town. It was initially estimated at magnitude 5.5. Intensity 4 was felt in the towns of Don Marcelino and Jose Abad Santos. State seismologists say aftershocks are expected.
Malacañang extends the tenure of officers in charge of agencies in the executive branch, which were due to expire tomorrow, December 31st. The palace says the OICs will continue to perform their duties until a replacement has been appointed. Malacañang notes the extension is to ensure continuity in government operations. Among the government agencies still with acting chiefs is the Health Department.